Hey guys, thanks for joining me on Prado 150 out of here. Just had to get my coffee from Milk and Honey. It's my favourite coffee place. Just going to be hitting some tracks down at Lockyer Valley. And we're also going to check out some of the things that we've done to the car in preparation to go to Cape York and any other trips that we do. Hey guys, how you going? Looks like it's a bit wet out here. So we should be in for a bit of a few puddles and that kind of thing. Just going to air down the tyres. Like to go down to about 18, I think. Oh, well, there we go, guys. Just drop the tyres down to about 18 to 20. See how we go on these tracks. It looks like there's a bit of water around, so there should be a few puddles. What I thought I might do is, while the car's still nice and clean, just might go through all the mods that we've done so far to the Prado 150. So we'll show you around, hey? So what it is, I'll start off with these tyres that we've put on. So these are the open country Toyos. They're the RT, which is it's between the mud terrain and the all terrain. So what I like about them is that they've got two different patterns here. So the inside pattern is probably a bit more for the on-road bitumen in the wet, that kind of thing, and the off-road, the all-terrain style. And on the outside is, it's a bit chunkier, so that covers you know, your muddy tracks and you know, rocky climbs, that type of thing. It's just, we probably use, this is like a 50-50% on-road, 50% off-road. So and in view of going up to the Cape, that's why we decided to get these. I've had some good reviews. We wanted a pretty solid sidewall on our tyre, and I think this fits the bill. So we'll let you know how it goes. It's done about 5,000 k's so far, and I suppose this is the first time since we've had them that we've taken them off road. We had the Coopers before that. They were a Coopers all-terrain. They were a very good tyre. Probably wore them down to about 40-50%, and when I got these new ones, I traded the Coopers in, and they were happy to give me some money as a trade-in, so that's pretty good. So Next in line here, we've got our rock sliders. They were done by, they're made by Southern Cross Fabrications. They're in Stapleton, which is in Brisbane, Queensland. They're down at down by Yatla. So if you're ever going down that way, make sure you grab yourself a pie from the Yatla Pies and go and get yourself some rock sliders. They've been excellent. We've just chosen to go with this one. They're fairly easy to install. They make them for obviously whatever car that's required. They've been great, great service. They were busy for a while last year with COVID, so we had to wait for a while. But we already bent the standard Prado side steps, gave them a good old banana bend. But these ones, I think these have saved the car already on one occasion, so we're very, very, very happy with them. So moving along, we've got this bull bar from Iron Man. I bought it because it looks good. I also have bought it because of it. We needed it for the somewhere to put the winch, and yeah, I just like the look of them pretty much, and they came in at the right price, so we got that from Iron Man at Toowoomba. And like I said before in my previous video, I was a bit nervous about putting it on myself, only because of the airbags and that type of stuff. But however, my 16-year-old son Joshua, he's not here at the moment, he convinced me that that we could put it on. So I said, all right, we'll give it a go. So we used the expertise of a friend that knows how to or builds racing cars, so he had a fair idea of kind of what goes on in relation to the chassis. However though, Joshua, well, he got into it, he got stuck into it, and we have the bull bar mounted onto the front of the Prado, including installing a winch. It's a Ridge Rider winch. It's a 12,000 pound, as you can see just in there. And we've probably used it twice since we've had it, but it's like having a bit of insurance, isn't it? Particularly like today, because I'm on my own. I couldn't pull the kids out of school today. And it's much better using the winch, I think, than damaging your car when you're in one of those precarious situations. So well, we've been very happy with it so far. It's a Ridge Rider, as you can see there. While we're looking at the bull bar, but it's just a no-name light bar there. We've had that for a while now, and I know it's probably not in the most correct position, but we did have it mounted underneath, and we had all sorts of wind noise. So as far as practicality goes, and no noise, and out of the way of the controller for the winch, we've mounted it up there. Just moving to the other side of the car, we've got the other rock slider there, obviously. And these good looking tyres. Now this awning, it's almost at the end of its life. We used to own a patrol prior to this car, so this awning's probably a good 5 years old, I'd say, and it's done us well. The only thing I'd say is that it's just a bit small for what we need it for, but again, in saying that, it's held out in some of the weather that we've put it in, and it's done a great job. We obviously got that from King's. The roof rack there is just a standard roof rack. I wanted the bars at the top there just to help keep everything in. So again, that came from Four Drive Super Centre. It's fairly sturdy and mounted pretty well there. So we've been pretty happy with it. I'll go to the top in a minute, but we've got a permanent mounted solar panel which feeds into our dual battery, which I'll show you that later too. On the back here, we were going to go for a 270 awning. However, we thought we'd give this one a go. This was a really, really good price at Anaconda. We probably had that for about, I don't know, 7 months or so. And as you'll see in a minute, when we're working from the back of the car,
that provides us with protection from all the elements. But again, yep, being very happy with that, and that's withstood a few windy, rainy days. Now, to Joshua's disgust, we don't have a full-on proper 3-inch exhaust. That's what he wants to get. At the moment, we just couldn't quite justify that in relation to spending the money on that, and we had a few other things that we needed to get for the car. So I had to appease him, and we've done a little bit of a modification to the exhaust system. Now, Joshua's added that onto the back there because he says it looks good, but as you can see, it just goes into the standard exhaust pipe. We've just cut something out of there just to give it a bit of noise, and in actual fact, I'll see what you think, but I think it sounds pretty good. And then we have the Safari snorkel. Again, I think it looks pretty good. It suits our purpose. I've done a bit of research on it, and I think for what we use it for, I think it was the best option. As you can see, it just goes into the air box through there. Another one of those jobs that Joshua said, "Hey Dad, we can do this," and I went, "Oh, don't know about cutting a hole into the guard of the side of the car." And it took me a while to think about it, and I went, "Well." And I think it looks pretty good. It suits our purpose. I've done a bit of research on it, and I think for what we use it for, I think it was the best option. As you can see, it just goes into the air box through there. Another one of those jobs that Joshua said, "Hey Dad, we can do this," and I went, "Oh, don't know about cutting a hole into the guard of the side of the car." And it took me a while to think about it, and I went, "Well, might as well give it a go." So again, with the help of a friend that kind of had a bit of experience with this, and I'll show you that later, us doing that. I'll put that on shortly. So we did the hole, followed the instructions, and as a result, we've got a snorkel mounted. We just had to obviously make sure that we had everything sealed up inside. I'll show you something we need to get fixed on the airbox once I open up the bonnet, but we definitely will need to get that fixed before we go crossing any deeper water crossings. But so far it's been great, and Joshua loves to open the window and listen to the air being sucked into the snorkel. He's even turned the ram part around just to be able to hear the noise better. Joshua is all about sound, looks, and doing mods. So while we've got the wheel turned like that, I don't know if you can see very well, but it's a bit dirty in there. But we've got the 2-inch suspension lift, and we've just gone with the 2-inch. We haven't changed anything else apart from the springs and the shockies. So we've gone there to give us a bit more height, and also just to count for having the bull bar and the winch on the front, and you know, the extra battery that we didn't have before. In the back, we already had put airbags in the back because we were towing a rather heavy camper trailer. You probably can't really see them there. But yeah, we already had the airbags in there, and we just added the suspension later to it. Again, it was a job that Joshua said that we can do. So we did that in our garage, and we did the airbags to start with. We had success with that. and I went and got some advice because obviously doing the putting the springs in and the shockies, we've already done the job once because you take all that out when you put the airbags in, and it was just a matter of doing it again and putting the bigger springs in. So we did the back there, the rear, we did that ourselves. But with the front, I didn't feel as confident with the front, only because of all the steering in there, and it would have needed a wheel alignment anyway. So I elected to go with the professionals, so we got them to do that. And they were a great help. They answered any questions or worries or concerns I had. And they gave me confidence and said, well, if you've done airbags in the back, you can do the suspension. So far, so good. The other thing we added in the back here was these link bars, linkages there, just to help a little bit with the flexing and how, you know, now that we've got the bit of extra height. The good thing about these tires, I went up one size, so these are a 265/70/17s. The Coopers that we had before that, they were a 265/65. So you notice a difference with them, especially when you're getting in. A couple of times I've kind of tripped over the rock sliders there just because it's a bit higher. So I'm hoping that gives us a little bit more clearance as well, and it'll get us ready for Cape York. Guys, thanks for watching Prado 150 out of here. See me in the next video where I complete showing you the modifications for our Prado.